Have you faced error like this? This and this? Do not worry, as I have the solution to this problem. Thanks to this amazing developer, whose Twitter name is AppInstallerIOS, who created this amazing one in a world application called Blacklist application. So without wasting further time, let's start with the video. On my iPad Pro, let me show you the same error which I am facing when launching a revoked app, which is unable to verify app. This basically means that Apple has blacklisted this app certificate. And if I go ahead and launch the settings app and navigate to VPN and device management, you can see that it shows verifies, yet the app is revoked. Now to solve this issue and unrevoke the application certificate, just go back and tap on the revoked app, and then just launch the blacklist app. So when you first install and launch this app, you will get a pop-up like this. Just tap on OK. Now just tap on Fix Blacklist, and next you will see a message which says done. That's simple. Now go back and launch the revoked applications. And as you can see, the app which was revoked is now launching successfully without any error. So all the applications under the same certificate will start working again like before. So before I tell you how I installed the Blacklist app, this will only work in iOS 16.1.2 down to iOS 16.0, and iOS 15.7.1 down to iOS 15.0. Next up on your iPad, visit this website, zeus.me, to download the Blacklist IPA file. Under Mac Dirty Cow Apps, tap on Browse, and on the next page, scroll down and locate Blacklist, tap on IPA, and on the next page, tap on IPA, and if you are fast enough, just tap on Download, to download the Blacklist IPA file. Once the IPA file is downloaded, next step is very important, as you need to install Scarlett or Altstore using computer method only. Look nowhere, as I have provided the link to both the videos, so install it first before moving forward. For this video, I will use the Scarlett method to sideload the Blacklist IPA file. Make sure the iOS device is connected to the computer throughout the entire process. Once the Scarlett is installed on your iOS device, launch the app, and tap on the sideload icon as shown on the video. Next, on the top right corner, tap on the sideload icon, and select the Blacklist IPA file. Now if you get an error like this, just remove Scarlett from the app switcher. To do that, just swipe up from the navigation bar, just the way I am doing, and swipe the Scarlett app to remove it. Now just disconnect and reconnect your iOS device to the computer, and on your computer, search for Scarlett Cloud, and run it as an administrator. This will open two windows. On the black screen, it should show that your device is connected. On the white screen, just click on Select Device, and then click on the code. This code represents your iOS device. Once done, on the black screen, it should show requesting NSAID. Now move back to your iOS device while it is connected to the computer and launch the Scarlett app, and this time sideload the Blacklist app as shown on the video. Make sure the device is always connected to the computer with Scarlett Cloud running as administrator. And as you can see, after loading to 100%, the Blacklist app is successfully sideloaded in iOS device using Scarlett, and it will expire in 7 days, so do not forget to refresh it before expiration. Check my next video to know how to refresh apps using Scarlett method. If you like this video, do like, comment, and subscribe.